And Ed, maybe you can react to this. Jill Wine Banks over at MSNBC laid out a path that would end up with a President Pelosi at the end of it. Watch.
Does anything change if Donald Trump is no longer at the top of this sort of, you know, web of corruption, but Pence is then at the top of it?
You could impeach Pence first. The problem is that Donald Trump then has to name his replacement. But I think that maybe a deal could be struck where he was told, if you don't make a replacement, then Nancy Pelosi does become president.
Here's the argument, gentlemen. If Trump and Pence are both implicated in this non-scandal scandal, Pence's resignation or removal from office occurred first. Trump could nominate a new vice president under the 25th Amendment. Rejection of a Trump vice presidential choice would then elevate Pelosi to in the event that Trump's removal from office after an impeachment trial in the Senate. Yeah. Now, this is the level of fantasy, Ed, that they're engaged in. Again, look, they're dreaming. They say it's a solemn moment, but they're dreaming of impeachment fantasies. They're supposed to be dreaming about the holiday season. No, yeah. This is their partridge in a pear tree.
Well, it makes me wonder who in the Democratic Party thought of rolling all of this out on Halloween and handing the president, you know, this great talking point about a witch hunt. It seems odd, but now you're talking about fantasy land, not Halloween, which is that we're going to, well, first we do this, then we do that. They haven't even impeached him yet, let alone removed him with a trial in the Senate. And as you know, there are a lot of Democrats in private who will admit, and it's not just Republicans saying this, it's going to be a heavy lift, even if they impeach him in the House, where they may have the votes, because Nancy Pelosi's in charge, as you laid out. Removing him from the Senate is a much higher mountain to climb, and is highly unlikely as we look at the facts tonight. So this is fantasy.
Byron. That is, in fact, a coup fantasy. I mean, we've seen a lot of misuse of that word around here, but the idea that somehow you could depose Trump, depose Pence, and make Nancy Pelosi president is not a good look for them, because it actually is a coup fantasy. And besides, you're right, both Clinton and Nixon were impeachment occurred after they'd been reelected. This time, we've never seen this happen before, and you have the opposition party. And the Democrats hope that if they handle this well, they will damage Trump's chances for re-election.
It looks like election meddling. They ran for 2 years, that Trump was working with the Russians to meddle with the elections. This looks like you're trying to disenfranchise 60-plus million people from voting for this president.
It's kind of simple. If you don't want Trump to win, beat him. It's a year away, folks. Just beat him. Nominate somebody sane and try to beat him. They know
that.
They can't beat him.
They got to do it with Warren, or they got to do it with Biden.
Maybe
and
Hillary.
Both of them.
Maybe Hillary.
Or maybe someone else. All right, gentlemen, thank you. We had so much more to get to on this Halloween Fright Night.